Is that started?
Go ahead and read that scripture again.
Yeah.
Revelation 14 and 9. And the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, If any man worship the beast in his image and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation. And he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels, in the presence of the Lamb. And the smoke of their torment ascendeth up forever and ever.
And so that smoke of that torment forever and ever, that's when America, the Lord destroys America, turns it into a lake of fire. Then it's going to be smoking forever. You know what I'm saying? That's a description of a great destruction and a great fire devouring this whole nation. And then when it said whoever received the mark of the beast, what did it say about whoever received the mark? Can you get this mark of the beast on camera? Just get the microchip on camera.
The same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation.
Yeah, so whoever takes this microchip, you're going to be destroyed. That's the end of you. You know what I'm saying? You're going to be destroyed. And the mark of the beast is a microchip. Okay? You ain't going to get on a Coda bus on camera. You won't even be able to get on a Coda bus without the microchip. You're not going to be able to get EBT without the microchip. If you don't have the microchip, no food stamps for you. Okay? If you don't have the microchip, you can't get a job. You definitely can't get a check cash. Already you can't get a check cash without an ID. Okay, well that's all computerized already.
There goes Daryl.
Even an ID is already computerized. That's why you all have numbers. Because you're not people, you're numbers. You're cattle.
You see Daryl?
Huh?
Daryl?
Yeah, see these people, they don't know what's coming, man. We live in the age of technology. Okay, if y'all didn't know, we're in the future. Okay, this is the age of technology, the age of computers. And soon they're gonna start microchipping everybody. That's a fact. They've already planned it. Google have been experimenting with putting microchips in people's brains for years. And they stated so. It's not a conspiracy. We're not making it up. They said it themselves. Hey, we've created microchips for the human brain. But people don't believe you. That's good though. And people's gonna justify, well, I get that chip. If I don't get that chip, my baby can't eat.
I can't play my PlayStation.
You can't get online on the PlayStation Network without the chip. So you know they're gonna take that chip. If you gotta have the chip to play Madden, you know they're gonna take it. Think about it. They can't get no Swisher Sweets or no blunts for their weed without the microchip.
No Ford Locos.
Huh?
Can't walk free.
You can't do nothing with it. Right, the cop can stop you. Yeah. Yep, because they just scan you, hitting you with a scanner. Like, oh, he's unchipped. Get him.
Terrorist.
You got a warrant.
He's a terrorist. Just like on that, it's like some Total Recall type shit. Or what's that? Yeah, Total Recall. You seen the new Total Recall? But wasn't that Colin Farrell? And their microchips were so advanced, they had watches and computers and everything inside their hands. Because soon, yeah, your smartphone's just going to be in your arm. People are going to be on Facebook on their arm, like, doo, 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 doo.
You got that little thing, yeah. Turn like that, right?
Yup. That's how they going
to
do it.
I was going to say, because that bishop, they got the thing, put your hand on there, and it shows your veins. So that's just a closer step. And like I said before, Sweden got 95% of their whatever Catholic society.
Is it Sweden or is that Denmark? I think it's Denmark.
Denmark's trying to.
Oh, okay. Because they're both through all them Scandinavian countries. The Scandinavia has turned into libtard central. Okay? Because the so-called Jew, Esau, got total control of those countries. That's why they flooding Sweden full of all those Somalians and all those Muslims. They got Muslims just running around raping Sweden bitches. Hey, that's good though, man. You dumbass.
The Philippines too.
Yeah, everywhere. They doing it all. It's worldwide. It's the Jew World Order. Yeah, might as well.
they have no rest day nor night, who worship the beast in his image. Whosoever receiveth the mark of his name. Yeah. Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of God in the faith of Yahusha.
Not the faith of this goddamn system. The beast.
Yeah, because too many people out here, they got, yeah, they love this government. They love this raggedy ass country. You have to be insane to love this country. You have to be mentally retarded to love this country.
That's good. That's good. Because you know what? We out here to arouse these motherfucking animals.
Yep. That's why exactly animals. She thought we was atheists. Because of the Caesar Bojair picture. Because she knew Jesus was a white man. Because you know,
these motherfuckers speak before they even know what's going on.
You know what? I'm not putting this down. I'm just going to keep holding this up.
Yeah, fucking fool.
Well, they do this once an hour.
Oh, there goes my girl again.
And you don't see none of these other Israelite groups out here warning people about the mark of the beast either.
Israel.
When they steadily implement this microchip more and more every day, you can just see it coming. You gotta be stupid not to see it coming. It's a total system of control. Karagma, which means to. That's where you get the word cave. Karagma means mark. The Greek word is right here. It's right here. Get it on. That's the word, the Greek word for mark. In the original Greek scripture, is karagma. And you can look the definitions right there.
That's what it means.
That's the motherfuckers trying to say it's Christianity. Not Christianity. What makes trying to say?
They said it's Christianity.
Yes.
Are you not keeping the law? You're following false doctrine.
Oh, or is it embargo?
That doesn't even make no sense. That's retarded. That's why they're all gonna be destroyed. Well, Nate, they're all cops. Anybody that's a cop, they can't be trusted.
Yep.
All cops are all sellouts. They're all traitors to their own people. There's no justifying being a cop. All they do is rob and pillage and take everyone's hard-earned money. Because they work for the devil. The cops work for the devil. Because they call them what? Law enforcement. They work in law enforcement. What laws are they enforcing? Are they stopping faggots? They say, come here, faggot. We gotta kill you because that's what the laws in the Bible say. No, they're not. They're enforcing the laws of the devil. That's what laws they're enforcing. So if anybody is a cop, a cop can't be trusted, okay? Yeah, that's bottom line. So that dude Nathaniel, he's a faggot. He's a traitor. You know what a punishment for
treason.
For treason? For a high, that's high treason. You know what the punishment for treason is death. It's the only punishment. The only punishment.
According to the United States government, we're committing treason right now.
Oh, he said we're committing treason. Oh, yep.
I'm trying to downfall this motherfucking nation.
Shit. Man, fuck this nation, man. This ain't even a nation. This is a corporation. Well, a corporatocracy.
A business.
It is a business. That's why when you come into Columbus, you're driving down the street, you see signs that say Columbus Corporation Limit. When you come into Columbus, why do you see a sign that says Columbus Corporation Limit? Because Columbus is a corporation. It's a subdivision of the bigger corporation, which is the United States, which is a part of the British Empire. But the schools, that's why the school system, that's the food system. You know what I'm saying? They take your little children, snatch them away from their parents at a young age, then they ship them off to a school to be washed over by strangers all day, and they pump their head full of lies. make them go to school every day, get them ready for a lifetime of slavery. That's all a school system is. The school system is just designed to make you a good slave. That's all it's for.
Goodness.
That's it. Make little ass children wake up at 0:30 in the damn morning.
Crying and shit, man.
Yeah, crying. I don't want to go to school. And their mom be happy to get rid of them too, because these hoes, they be happy to get rid of their kids. That's a babysitter for them. So while their children in school,
she goes suck some dick.
They being hoes all day. Yeah, you get bullied. They don't care. They still can't deal with it. Man up, nigga. I hate it. School was torture for me, man. I hated it. I hated every last second of it. Yeah, I'll show you the real knowledge right here. If I can get it. Yet to find the gloves where you can turn pages with. Proverbs 1:7. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction. So the fear of the Lord, that's the beginning of knowledge. But in Columbus public schools, you're not allowed to teach the Bible in the schools. That's because the school system's satanic by design. Yeah, you get kicked out of school for reading the Bible. So fuck the school system. The fuck the government. Fuck all this shit. Fuck America. The God's gonna destroy America. Hey, get Amos 9:8.
I'm about to give you destruction.
Oh, go ahead. Just give me destruction.
Revelation 14:13. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord from henceforth. Yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from the laborers, and their works do follow them. And I looked, and behold, a white cloud upon the cloud one sat like unto the Son of Man, having on his head a golden crown, and in his hand a sharp sickle.
Because the Lord, when he comes down with that sickle, because he's the Lord of the harvest. There's going to be a great harvest. Like the scriptures say, the harvest is plenteous, but the laborers are few. You know what I'm saying? Ooh. Keep going.
And another angel came out of the temple, crying with a loud voice to him that sat on the cloud, thrust in thy sickle and reap, for the time is come for thee to reap.
Yeah, so the Lord, so the real grim reaper is actually the Lord, the one they call Jesus Christ, Yahweh Shai. That's his, the Lord's name is not Jesus Christ. His Hebrew name is Yahweh Shai. Okay, that's the Lord, and he's the reaper, okay? Keep going.
For the harvest of the earth is ripe, and he that sat on the cloud thrust in his sickle on the earth, and the earth is ripe. And another angel came out of the temple which is in heaven, he also having a sharp sickle. And another angel came out from the altar which had power over fire, and cried with a loud cry to him that had the sharp sickle, saying, thrust in thy sharp sickle and gather the cluster of the vine of the earth, for her grapes are fully ripe. And the angel thrust in his sickle into the earth and gathered the vine of the earth and cast it into the great winepress of the wrath of God. And the winepress was trodden within the city, and blood came out of the winepress even unto the horse, even unto the horse's bridles.
That's bad, man.
By the space of 1,600 furlongs.
So the Lord is terrifying. And when the Lord returns to this earth, these people out here, they're going to be terrified. Okay, it's going to be the scariest day the earth has ever witnessed. Okay, because the Bible says the day of the Lord is darkness and not light. There will be no light in it. None. I got a scripture to back you up, because he said the Lord's going to, he said that the clusters of the grapes was full and all that. Let me get this real quick, because the Lord said he's the vine. John 15:5. I am the vine, ye are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me, ye can do nothing. If a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch and is withered, and men gather them and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. So yeah, if you ain't abiding in the Lord, you're gonna get burned up. That's all there is to it. Go ahead with that.
In Amos 9 and 8. For behold, the eyes of the Lord's power are upon the sinful kingdom, and I will destroy it from off the face of the earth.
Yeah, America's a sinful kingdom. That's why in America, faggots can get married. So, you know a place where faggots can get married? Muslims gonna walk around freely. They got transsexuals walking around. You know this is a sinful nation. So the Lord said he's gonna destroy it from off the face of the earth. And that's gonna be a beautiful thing. It's gonna be beautiful.
You got a nigga, that nigga on the, remember the dude on the, you messaged me about the motherfucker that he was, he know he a Hebrew Israelite.
Oh, that Muslim, but he said he a Muslim.
This motherfucker say he know he a Hebrew Israelite from the tribe of Judah, but and he Muslim.
But he's a Muslim.
Right.
Cause he said Muhammad's his brother.
Man, people like that, can't save him, man. You can't save him. What's the point even talking to him?
Then he threatened us with violence.
Yeah,
he said he gonna see us on the corners and he gonna pretty much, he said he's gonna kill us.
What you, I mean, what's the point, man? You can't, that motherfucker
can't talk to nobody like that.
He gotta be vaporized and then born into the kingdom, man. You can't go in the kingdom with a state of mind like that.
Especially when you coming up against the men of the Lord who's already putting their lives on the line, doing the work, and then you threaten them?
You know, he did say that. He said something like,
"He gonna see
he's
you.
Gonna come see. I'm gonna see y'all out there on that corner."
You know, he's talking that Muslim.
And that
shit.
Was an old ass video
from a year ago.
Right, that's what I posted to him. I'm like, "Where you been? Where you been all this time?"
Well, we've been talking shit about Muhammad
you know
since then. Every day.
He ain't replied back. Should be my pleasure to have a motherfucker come out here like that. She come with the threats, man. Empty threats. That's what they think. They're going to pull your whole card and shit. You know.
Oh, I'm scared. I'm going to stop teaching now.
Bring it on out here, buddy. Bring it on. Bring it on.
You know, we can. That's all the Muslims do. Yeah, Muslims. Hey, man, Muslims are heathens, man. They ain't got no knowledge. See, a Muslim can't convert nobody through knowledge because they got no knowledge, right? The only way they can do it is through fear.
Dude,
through
over
violence.
That's fucking foul as fuck. Real grand.
Look, that's about to roll down the bitch right there.
Subway, hot berry.
Right.
Hot, whatever the fuck that is.
Go over there in the corner in the dark. Go over there where nobody can see that shit.
Yeah, man. That's foul.
Ugh.
Be catching a whiff of that nasty shit.
Right.
So you don't know what's done happen. They've done shit it out here and everything.
We come out here to prophesy, and that's exactly what we're going to do. You prophesying the downfall of fucking America.
Like I said, you gotta be retarded, man, to love this place. And to actually want, if you love being here and you wanna see this place prosper, if you wanna see Donald Trump save America,
make America great
make
again.
Make it a great, you're fucking retarded.
You're part of the problem.
You're a big part of the problem.
You know?
And you're our enemy. Yeah. You're the enemy of the Most High.
That's right. That's right.
And there's no discussing that.
Man, look, that piss is rolling right down to her feet.
That's nasty, man.
Yeah, this is fine. This is fine. This is fine shit. Oh well. That's America. That's
and
America.
Look at this, right behind us, every time I get out here, you gotta put that on camera. They got a big ass Roman temple right here. That's a temple. That's a temple to Jupiter. But oh, that's the state house though. That's the state house though. No, it's a temple, you dumbasses. That ain't a temple. I don't know what a temple is.
It's like you playing Zelda, about to go in there and get the compass, the map.
Yeah, you got a compass and the... No, that's not that. That's the city hall that look like the Zelda temple.
It do look like it was just lifted right out of Rome.
It is.
Right here.
That's a Roman temple.
Yeah.
That's where they go up there to worship goddamn Jupiter. And that's why the United States uses the eagle as their symbol, because the eagle is the symbol of Jupiter, the symbol of Zeus. That's a fact. That's why everything on the back of a dollar bill is written in Latin. Latin is not the language of America.
Latin?
That's the language of the Romans. And that's why they have Roman temples.
That's why they use Roman numerals.
That's why they use Roman numerals. That's why the Super Bowl, yeah, is written in Roman numerals. That's why they have a good point. That's why they have a Senate. That's why they said America's a republic. Man, you ain't see. We're in the know. We know what's going on. The average person, they ain't got a clue. Okay, because they've been brought up in this filth. You know, they don't know shit. And that's why you gotta get out here and teach, because these people don't know nothing.
Right. Here you go. This is Revelation 17:3. So he carried me away in the spirit into the wilderness, and I saw a woman sit upon a scarlet-colored beast, full of names of blasphemy.
Yeah, America is just full of all kind of blasphemies.
Having 7 heads and 10 horns.
Yep, and that's going to NATO. Oh, and Vladimir Putin just came out and said that NATO in America is a threat to Russian national security. And he pretty much said he gonna do something about it.
They gonna defend themselves.
They gonna defend themselves. Right, because they're on the defense. Right? Yeah. They're not trying to invade.
They're not offensive, right?
They're not
right.
You don't see Russia going around the world colonizing.
Yeah.
You know, they don't do that.
And Russia was invited into Syria to help protect them.
Yep.
America just going that motherfucker on its own wheel. Like,
yeah, Putin came out and spilled the beans on everything. Putin told you that the United States government is funding ISIS. They're funding Al-Qaeda. Yeah, and Turkey. Turkey's funding. Well, Turkey, they're Edomites. The Turkish people are Edomites, just like those fake Jews are Edomites.
Yeah, they're trying to bring back the Ottoman Empire.
Yep, they're trying to come back with the Ottomans.
Yeah.
And they already said that Erdogan, how the hell you say his name, right, that he was the head of the caliphate.
Woo!
Mm. Yeah, those are Edomites over there.
That's some shit. And the woman.
Oh, my fault. Then you got these stupid Moors, like the Moorish nation, wearing the fez cap, going back to, they found the ways of Esau. I tell you how stupid they are. And you gotta be retarded to put a funny ass hat, like the Shriner hat type deal on your head.
That stupid ass movie Spike Lee just came out where they got it up. Dumb ass niggas wearing the fez.
Ain't nothing cool about that, man. There is nothing cool about the fez.
You know, giving reference to homosexual shit, so just letting you know on a low level, like in a little secret message, that they involved with some faggot shit too.
Well, they said the Muslims over there in Afghanistan said that little boys are for fun and women are for children.
Yeah, that's in the Quran.
Yeah, they call the little boys pearls. It's in the Quran.
Pearls, little beautiful pearls.
Beautiful pearls. That's foul, man.
Yeah, that's foul. And the woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet color, and decked with gold and precious stones and pearls, having a golden cup in her hand full of abominations and filthiness of her fornication.
Yeah, tell me America ain't full of abominations and filthiness, man. Just look at the street. They got damn piss rolling down the street as we speak.
Literally
just piss, and they be shitting. You got faggots walking around. You got cops robbing everybody, taking all your money. Yeah, man.
Norway, man.
They played, and look at it. They took a one-time Columbus. All this used to be a beautiful forest with a beautiful Scioto River. I mean, it was beautiful at one time, right? They came through. They said, fuck your forest. Fuck your trees. Chopped them all down. Polluted the river. They just totally desecrated this whole area. And this used to be sacred.
Right, used
to be mounds. Actually, this area right here, that's why we got Mound Street right down. Why do they call it Mound Street? Because up and down it used to be sacred burial grounds where they had buried the Gadites would bury their loved ones. And they had they still got that big ass mound way down on Mound Street up on we used to roll down when we was little. You know, you go way down Mound all the way down on the west side, way down there. I forget where it's at. We should go out there one day. Big ass Indian mound right in the middle of the city. There's one right here too.
This one was
there's two of them. That's why I was telling, when it's more daylight, we should go get all these statues on camera. There's a lot of abominable shit out here, man.
Oh yeah.
Like the scriptures say, man, this is a nation of filth and abominations, man. A cop will pull you over for jaywalking or riding a bike on the sidewalk, give you a ticket. They won't stop a faggot though, will they? They won't stop a Muslim. They won't go and arrest the Jews or the bankers. They won't touch them. They're protecting them. Fucking faggots.
And upon her forehead was a name written, Mystery Babylon the Great.
Yeah, Mystery Babylon the Great. Because America embraces the philosophy of Babylon, the philosophy of Nimrod. Go ahead.
Mystery Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots and abominations of the earth.
Oh, and don't they say even America was founded by Freemasons? George Washington, well-known Freemason. And everybody knows the Freemasons, what do? They practice that ancient Babylonian mysteries. They call it the mystery schools. Go ahead. Okay. Since we in Revelation time, we might as well get Revelation 19. Oh, Hugo Chavez.
I got him.
He looks just like him. And they assassinated Hugo Chavez. He got sick quick and died, didn't he? Yeah, Daniel's good too.
Which one in 19?
The Wrath. The Fierce Wrath of the Almighty. That's one of my favorite scriptures.
It's not rolling today.
I don't know, man. I've been sick as fuck for the past 2 weeks. There goes James Hetfield. Get him. People be looking funny to me, man. At least you do got his beard. A lot of these faggots, they walk around just shaved. They got the big ass shaving. Oh, man. What the fuck is that? Why they got a big ass number 8 up there? What is that all about?
That's 8.
Is that the octagon? A lot of people say the number 8, like you get an 8-point star. You know, the 8-point star is a cuneiform symbol that means Anu, which means, you know, it was the Sumerian word for God.
You see who owns that building?
Who, Wiley?
Wiley.
What, how you say it?
Wilder.
Wilder. Oh, Wilder, yeah. But yeah, you see the cuneiform symbol for God is it's an 8-point star. That's where you get the word Anunnaki. So maybe that 8 has something to do with that. I don't know.
The Jew bastard that owns that building.
Oh, the one with the 8?
Yeah. And also the number 8 is also an affinity.
Jews own everything down here.
Yeah.
He owns half of what's down here.
Yeah, Wilder. Yeah, that's one of the richest people in Columbus. Probably the richest. So them fake ass Jews, they own this whole city. They own the whole country. Hell, they running the whole world.
You go out in the middle of the country, you see his signs out there, property for sale.
Property.
There's your homie.
Oh, someone got marked.
I marked like a bum. I marked up.
You know, that shit smells like a rotten trash can.
That gives true definition to junk in the trunk. That's some junk in that trunk.
You hit that from the back, gravy going to start coming out.
Like, gravy? Bus filled gravy. Pus-filled hole.
You wouldn't even clean it up first, would you?
Yeah, you like the scripture say, remember the King Cyrus? Oh, that was Cyrus. Who was Xerxes in the book of Esther? How he made all of his wives bathe in the perfumes and stuff for like a year before he would even have sex with them. They made sure they was clean. You know what I mean? And these girls get mad if you tell them to take a shower.
No, bitch, go clean your coochie.
Yeah, it's gross, man. It's gross even thinking about it. Because that's why the scripture of Isaiah said, let's get the book of Isaiah. They said, instead of sweet smell, there shall be stink. Talking about these women. That's in the book of Isaiah. Oh, you ain't got it.
You ever pull down a pair of panties and just about puked after you smelled it?
I can't talk about it no more.
Many times, bro.
Same here. I guess that's better than being a fucking non-pussy getter.
Oh, man. I'm really... It's upset my stomach.
That's
right
controversial.
Now.
That's controversial.
I got a weak stomach tonight. Just the thought of it just making me cringe. Yeah. You and your queens? Oh my god. That's heavy.
Oh shit. Woo-wee.
There's my wife right here. This is the truth.
You hit it before?
Oh, man, come on.
No. I just remember her from back in the day, man.
Oh, really?
That's why. Actually, I remember her from the 70s.
Oh, man, that's why she waved at you.
Nah, she ain't right. Swimming up in at the swimming pool up in Winston.
Oh, yeah?
Here we go, bro. Here we go. Isaiah 3:16, moreover the Lord said, because the daughters of Zion are haughty, and walk with a stretched forth neck and wanton eyes, walking and mincing as they go, and making a tinkling with their feet. Therefore the Lord will smite with a scab the crown of the head of the daughters of Zion, and the Lord will discover their secret parts.
Yep, their secret parts. I mean, you ain't need us to break that down, do they?
Therefore, the Lord will smite. In that day, the Lord will take away the bravery of their tinkling ornaments about their feet and their clothes and their round tires like the moon, the chain and the bracelet and the buckle.
Yeah, Louis Anderson driving the bus, or look at it. Big fat pork grease slurping. Just all fat and just.
The bonnets and the ornaments of the legs and the headbands and the tabas and the earrings, the rings and the nose jewels, the changeable suits of apparel and the mantles.
You standing right on that piss.
He got his J's on too.
I guess it don't hurt if you don't know.
It's just water. It can't hurt you. Right. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Where the water coming from?
The glasses and the fine linen and the hoods and the belts. And it shall come to pass that instead of sweet smell, there shall be stink.
Yeah, so according to the Bible, it said instead of sweet smell, there shall be stink. We all know that's true.
For real. And instead of a girdle, a rent. And instead of well-set hair, baldness.
Baldness, that's why all these women got to wear weaves. Can't grow hair. That's a curse from the Lord. Yeah, weaves, wigs, get wearing horse hair and all kind of madness.
It's unbelievable.
Some fake hair, huh?
Unbelievable.
Unbelievable. That's because they are undisciplined.
Yep.
They're some wandering hoes, man. Wonder. Like the scripture says, a woman shall surpass a man. And surpass meaning she's gonna just not listen and just go on her own business, you know?
She's an independent woman.
Doing her own thing, right.
Independent woman.
Dude over there tap dancing in the piss.
And he done been walking all in that piss. He don't even know it's piss. Nasty motherfuckers pissing on the streets and
nasty,
shit, man.
You know these people ain't drinking
fucking
no water.
50 people
all they do
out
is drink
here.
Liquor, beer, and.
Oh, God, here comes.
And pop, so there ain't no clean piss.
Got Medusa coming this way.
That's the one that was talking shit or something?
Oh, no, I'm just saying. She all loud. You can hear her coming from a mile away. Another bus stop. Oh, I hope so. Yeah, don't come over here.
Undisciplined.
You talking about that old white lady?
That one that's standing right there. She,
yeah, she was hot.
The bitch off the grid? Or the one hit my vape?
She was actually listening to it.
Yeah, I was talking about somebody else.
Oh, yeah, you talking about the blind girl?
Yeah.
No, she was cool.
Yeah, she was bad.
She was cool, though.
You want to talk shit like black bitch.
Yeah. Well, she wasn't talking shit, though. She was just dumb. She just didn't understand. She seen this picture of Caesar Borgia. She thought that meant we didn't believe in Jesus or something.
Okay. All right.
You know what I mean? She didn't.
Well,
she was
typical
just
a woman.
Yeah, typical woman. She just don't know nothing.
Like
so they wasn't.
Like
they wasn't scoffing.
Right.
Well, you know they scoffing. They all just natural.
Oh, yeah. They get some distance between you and them.
Those motherfuckers was crazy.
Oh, tell Chin the story about your boy.
Nah, your one girl's like, you was cute though.
Tell Chin about your boy saying his. Friend's wife was trying to fucking.
Oh, did I tell you about that, my dude? My dude Josh.
You ain't gotta say his name.
No, I gotta say his name. Name's Josh.
Burrows. Got him.
Got him. But yeah. Now, he said some dude's wife was trying to fuck him, right?
Right.
And I said, don't you know, because they're from the bottoms. These are direct. They don't know nothing, you know what I mean?
Right.
But I was like, you know that's adultery, right? He said, adultery? I'm 20 years old. I was like, wow.
That's a surprise answer.
That was crazy. I mean, that's because, man, they grow up in the hood.
I never thought that would come out.
But they grow up in the hood and they get taught nothing their whole life.
I would never even imagine that answer, man.
Because, I mean, that's how gone our people are. You know what
Look,
I'm saying?
This is what Mark said last night. We was with this hippie bitch.
I mean, he's a cool kid.
She knows all kinds of remedies and shit. Mark was like, you know any remedies to help cure cancer? She was like, yes, yeah, stop, quit smoking.
Yeah.
Right.
He was salty as fuck.
That's Israel. Israel's supposed to be stupid at this time.
Well, I'll be checking on your dude on a serious tip. What's that dude that Mike, not Hanson, Mike, that dude, the Natural News, the health ranger? Well, I say he posted shit talking about how ginger helps fight prostate cancer.
Ginger. Ginger
bad.
Ginger root.
Yeah, yeah, it's a ginger root.
I got ginger at home right now.
Like,
I never thought about making a tincture out of it. I'm sure
he got tinctures for everything.
Yeah, you know, hey.
He came over to my house with some honey.
Some bad shit, man.
He came over with a $9 bottle of honey. That shit, it was so delicious.
Yeah. $9?
Yeah. It was some pure.
Oh, you gotta try the shit I get then.
It costs more. Oh, that's cheap.
That's cheap.
That's that generic shit.
You know, vegans don't eat honey.
Well, I'm not a vegan.
I don't understand the logic behind that.
Because bees make it.
Right? Yeah, but I don't understand the logic behind it.
It's retarded.
It's still natural.
I ain't giving up cheese.
Honey ain't nothing but pollen.
Yeah.
You know, that's all it is.
And the bees is making it for you anyway.
That's right.
The best shit right there.
What is it bees?
Hash oil is pretty much the same shit.
They eat it too?
Oh, okay.
A bee, and you ever seen them birds that it's like sit still, can just...
The hummingbird?
Hummingbird.
Yeah.
They love that sweetness. It's like
gasoline. That's why they be on those nectar plants. The honeysuckle?
Yeah, bees go miles, man, and come back.
I love bees, man. I just sit and watch bees, let them land on me, and they just amaze me.
And they need very little of it, too, so... Take, you know, harvesting honey, man, is nothing. Taking it from them ain't nothing, man. Of course, the Most High gave us honey,
bee is like the most amazing of all the insects.
Look at the wasp.
Oh, let me show you the wasp. Well, I ain't letting a wasp land on me, though.
Your homie Fleet.
What is it?
Cordius, I don't know.
Huh?
The Bible thing.
My
coordinates.
Bees?
I got a scripture.
It's
Matthew 3 and 4.
Scripture speaks a lot of honey, too. And Most High give reference to the scriptures as honey.
And it recalls the promised land is the land of milk and honey.
And the same John had his remnant of camel's hair in a lantern girded about his loins, and his meat was locust and wild honey.
What you want me to look up, honey?
Yeah, milk isn't vegan either.
Yeah, honey can give you a lot of energy, you know what I'm saying? And you got like a sore throat, you can take like two, I think it's like tablespoons. But you got to keep on taking it daily, though, so for it actually affects you.
Well, my mom always told me when you get sick, you make the garlic and honey tea.
Yeah.
Boil some garlic with some honey, then drink it.
Yeah, I just drink it anyway. I mix honey, cinnamon, and lemon. I just drink it anyway, just all year long. I just drink it anyway.
Lipton makes a honey lemon natural herb tea.
Tasty too.
Yeah, it's nice, man. It's real nice.
Lipton natural herb honey lemon tea is the shit.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah.
They don't sell it everywhere either.
No, they sure don't. It costs
only in the white neighborhoods.
It costs a penny when you get it too.
It's like $4 a box.
That's expensive though. That's high, man.
All this shit in the stores and everything is way high. They came up with this new food called organic food, which is regular food. And now they've made it so regular food is now something special. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
What kind of madness is this?
It still ain't regular, though.
It's not nothing.
So they hear that, man.
Like Bradley said, in the future, everything will be artificial.
That's actually a Peter Thompson song.
It's cheaper to buy and make your own tea.
Well, Bradley said it, too.
Way. You can make way.
Add whatever
one. That's the song talking about smoking weed.
Hey, I bet all the weeds got GMO in it. Well, yeah.
No, it is. They all use the When they grow the weed, they use all that.
And they crossbreed
them. Crossbreed it. That's against the scriptures.
A lot of these drinks make like Minuteman.
It's all from concentrate. Plus, they add a bunch of stuff.
And it's made by enemy by Pepsi.
Man, all the corporate, they're all owned by so-called Jews. All by
why would you extract all the fucking juice and then fucking freeze it and then add water again to it? That don't make no sense.
It's pretty much saying like the bees, like a small insect.
Okay, I'm fine. Do you know, have an idea where it's at? Because there's a lot
it's like
of...
in Proverbs. Yeah,
okay.
I'm
fine.
In the scriptures, bee?
Yeah. Or bees. Or
there's a lot of them. Maccabees. That's why it popped up. My search engine even searches through the name of a
I got this right here.
So I got every last scripture in Maccabees.
That's Sirach 11:3. The bee is little amongst
that's it.
Fly.
Where's that at?
Sirach. But her fruit is the chief of sweet things.
Oh wow. Read that again. Read that again.
Sirach 11:3. The bee is little amongst such as fly. But her fruit is the chief of sweet things.
It's the chief of sweet things. Yeah, because back in the ancient world, yeah, because, you know, the elite and aristocrats, they try to keep the honey for themselves.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they sure do. Honey and cinnamon.
Cinnamon, oh, yeah.
They try to keep it all themselves.
That's why there was such a big deal to the Miranda spice trade. That's what made all those early explorers from the Britain so rich. They was going to, you know, they was... They wanted to go to all these different countries to get all those spices.
Samson, when he killed that lion, he came back and there was honey in there. He wanted to share it with his parents.
That's why the bears will go nuts over some honey. They eat it with the bees and everything.
Yeah. That's like better than sugar.
No, sugar's not good for you at all. Nah, it's the best thing.
They call it sugar the white death.
Yeah, it tears up your body.
So those meat packages can go to McDonald's or Wendy's or...
But now they don't even put real sugar in nothing no more. Everything's like sucralose now. I know when I put that sucralose in my body, like my brother was talking about it earlier. All these hot, you see those hot cocoa packets they sell at the store? Like, what is it, the Swiss made, or what did they call that stuff?
Swiss made.
All those hot
Swiss
mist. Yeah, Swiss mist. They all, it doesn't have sugar in it. It has sucralose in it, which is poison.
Yeah, it's designed to shock your immune system.
It does not taste good either.
Because I noticed it because years ago I was drinking it. It was making my body feel real weird. I was like, I just feel funny.
Like the same as drinking a Diet Coke.
Yeah, just like I didn't know about aspartame years ago, but I knew by what my body was telling me. It's like, how come every time I drink a diet soda, my body feels all fucked up? Mm-hmm. It's that aspartame and
that's
this poison.
That's how I'm from him talking about it all the time. That's how I found out about aspartame.
Yeah.
It's just some bad
and
shit,
now they're saying they about to take aspartame out of the drinks.
Yeah.
But I thought it was okay for you though. But why are you gonna take it out if it's okay?
Ain't that the main ingredient in Diet Coke?
Yeah.
Diet.
Yep.
Hey, it's worse.
Yeah,
it makes you go blind.
And they got chemicals in it that makes you...
You can taste it.
My stepdad, my mom's husband.
He went blind for like a year.
Drinking, guzzling Diet Cokes, went blind.
You can't tell him.
He's drinking it again, though, ain't he?
He kills it. He smashes it.
You can't tell him to stop. You can't tell him.
He'll be blind in a couple months.
The chemicals is like made so you drink.
Hey, they just gonna replace it with something else even worse.
Yeah, it's gonna be even worse.
Shit, they haven't even done more studies than aspartame.
I've heard conspiracy theories that they say they put saltpeter in the food still. In the, you know, you going to get your little TV dinners, they got saltpeter in it. I mean, you never know, man. You don't know what's in it. Just because even the ingredients label says something, that don't mean that's what you're getting. Right. You got Aldi's. Aldi's, they got caught passing off steak dinners as beef when it's actually
horse
meat.
Horses are legal for slaughter.
Burger King got caught with horse DNA in their burgers. They got caught with human DNA in their burgers. Different restaurants. What restaurant was that? Was that McDonald's?
I thought it was hot dogs.
No, yeah, well, hot dogs too.
I think it was McDonald's.
I think it was one of the restaurants. They found human DNA in the meat. That reminds me of that movie, y'all seen that movie Logan's Run? Oh, you gotta see that movie.
The Road.
That movie goes into the microchip. About how you have to have this chip. And if you don't get that chip, you know what I'm saying, you'll be considered a criminal. And the chip only lets you live to be like 30 or something in that movie. That's a real good, y'all ain't watching that video, go watch Logan's Run. That's a great movie. It's all about the microchip, pretty much. But then it came to find out in that movie, it's just like that other movie, Soylent Green, about how it is in the future, and they was feeding the people human flesh. That's what they was feeding people. They was taking all the dead bodies and processing it into food.
What movie was that?
Logan's Run.
Logan's, the recent one, though.
So I know there's a Soylent Green. There's a new one, too, though. I don't know.
I can't remember. The recent one is bad. I can't remember the name of it, though. I'm going to have to find that, though. The people getting used to it, though. They like eating human meat. I ain't gonna complain about that. What that moralist rat say, the lion Jew, he said, tell the people they ain't gonna believe it.